one really important thing about my work is that I work with found objects and high heat, different kinds of insulation materials.
Okay.
Like industrial insulations that are just usually used for like constructions.
How did you come to start applying high heat to them?
I think that my way of understanding materials is by looking for non-traditional ways. Like, you don't believe what you see, you only believe what you feel in your body. Mm-hmm. And this is also, I think, a really accurate way to describe how I work is it's very physical. It's very violent, like very expressive sometimes. And I like to feel things through my body when I work. Mm-hmm. And I think this is kind of how, like, this is kind of where the heat comes from.
Mm.
And finding those similarities between how like a plastic bag reacts to the heat in a way that kind of resembles like a scarred skin or a burnt skin. This was my way to kind of like explore a body that is deconstructed, a body that is wounded, and have this like all language of violence and trauma. When I came across this mattress, I ended up working on it like on an operation bed.
It's a real interesting hybrid. Let's talk a little bit about the pieces that are that utilize the yellow plastic. There's one that leans and like the folds of fabric.
Yeah.
And the other piece that is that ends in like a pile of, is it sand? Is it extruding sand?
Yeah, I think the idea of decay as something that we can see or smell or feel or something that we can sense with our senses, something invisible or something that happens underneath many layers, something that happens as a result of accumulations of materials is just interesting. But I think similarly about violence and the idea of what is violence as something that is not always visible or not always quantifiable. And very similarly to like the idea of decay, violence and decay is processes that happens both on the surface level, but also underneath many layers in a more slow, invisible state that shows in my work.